Today we're going to be learning about triangles. So let's start by learning about how to sort triangles based on the angles. There's three different types of angles that exist, which are the acute angle, the right angle, and the obtuse angle. Can anyone describe in words how you would locate an acute angle, how you would describe what an acute angle is? Yes?
Less than 90 degrees.
Yes. So this is less than 90 degrees. So that requires us to know what the right angle is, which is a 90 degree angle. And then the obtuse angle is greater than 90 degrees. So to classify triangles, for a triangle to be a right triangle, it needs to have only one right angle. Any triangle that has one right angle is going to be a right triangle. For an obtuse triangle as well, if it has one right angle, one obtuse angle, then it's an obtuse triangle. And for an acute triangle, all of the angles need to be acute in order for it to be an acute triangle. How many acute angles does a right triangle have? Yes, two. So is it possible for you to have an obtuse triangle that has more than one obtuse angle? Try drawing an obtuse triangle that has more than one obtuse angle and see what happens. Yeah, so you see that you can't connect the triangle when there's two angles that are wider than 90 degrees. Okay, so now we're gonna move on to the classification of the sides. By the sidelines, we classify triangles as isosceles or scalene. So an isosceles triangle has two sides that are the same length. By drawing a couple more isosceles triangles, can anyone see what this says about the angles? So let's say these two are the same length. Can anyone tell what this says about having similar or different angles in the isosceles triangle? Yes, Ari.
Both of the angles would be identical.
Yeah, so in the isosceles triangle, you have two angles that are the same and one that's different. And we mark the same length by this one line, and we can do the same for the angles. So that means these angles are the same and that one's different. All right, so for a scalene triangle, we have all three sides are different lengths. So we can mark that by doing one mark, two here, and three there. And can anyone see what that says about the angles in a scalene triangle? Are the angles going to be the same or different?
Different.
Yeah, so the angles in a scalene triangle are different. And then last of all, we have an equilateral triangle, which is also an isosceles triangle because it has two sides that are the same length, but this third side is also the same length. And in the equilateral triangle, all of the angles are also of equal length. Okay, so now we're gonna go and learn a chant to help us remember what we've learned today. So focus your attention over here. Okay. Equilateral, equal thing, lateral side. Obtuse triangles have one angle that's wide. Wider than a right angle in which would fit a square, the acute angle is smallest when compared. The scalene triangle is the hipster in the crew. It prides itself on differences, like the snowflake, where no two sides or angles are the same as in the isosceles, because this balanced triangle conforms to the proprieties. Angles, acute, right, obtuse, sides, isosceles, scalene. Who are we? The triangle machine.
On differences, like a snowflake where no two
sides or angles are the same as in the isosceles.
Sides or angles are the same as in the isosceles.
Because this balanced triangle conforms to the proprieties.
Because this balanced triangle conforms to the proprieties.
Okay, now we're all going to say angles, acute, right, obtuse. Ready? Angles.
Acute.
Right.
Obtuse.
And then sides.